Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. Excel has released some new functions recently, which could be a game changer for many of us, and that is what we are going to cover today. First up is GROUPBY. As the name indicates, this function is used to group your data by certain rows. The syntax of GROUPBY is on the screen. If you are intimidated by the number of arguments, wait for the next new function I'll show you. But don't worry, they are both fairly easy to understand and pretty useful. So let's check the arguments for GROUPBY function. First up is row fields, which is nothing but the rows which you wish to group your data by the row you wish. Next is values, which is again rows, which has the data which you wish to aggregate. Imagine the values box in a pivot table, which sums, averages a column that has numbers. Now comes function. This is what they have termed as eta reduced lambda. Basically, you can take it as various functions like sum, percent of, average, count, etc. provided to you. If you've checked my video on aggregate formula, it's similar to that functionality. These three arguments are mandatory and rest that follow are optional. Next up is field headers, which I'm sure you must have guessed are the headings for the fields. As it's optional, if you don't mention a value between 0 and 3 here, it will be automatic, which means if your data is presented in such a way that the first value is text and the second value is a number, then it assumes that your data has headers. Total depth determines whether you wish to show grand totals and or subtotals. You now also have the option to show them at the top, which is nice. Sort order has to be a number which corresponds to the columns in row fields argument followed by the column in the values argument. If sort order is in negative, rows are sorted in descending order. Last is filter array, which is similar to the filter box in pivot table and allows you to filter out desired values. I know it looks a lot, but it is pretty simple once you get the hang of it. You'll be using it in no time. So let's get you accustomed to GROUPBY with this example. Here we have some sales data of about 30 unique clients with their city, country, and region, and their respective revenue we receive from them and the profit that we earned. While analyzing this data, we normally do some basic stuff, like which city or country has provided us with the most revenue and some more stuff emanating from that. So let's do that with GROUPBY today. We'll start simple and use the mandatory arguments only for now, and gradually move on to cover all the arguments. So we start with GROUPBY, and for row fields argument, let's choose city column. So we start with the header and go all the way to the end. For values, let's just select the revenue. Again from the headers, right to the end. Next up is function, and we have all these options here. Apart from sum, percent of, we have count and count A, we have max, min, product, concat, which is short for concatenate function, which joins two values, array to text, and some more. Let's choose sum for now, and that completes all the mandatory arguments. So let's finish our formula with this argument. And here we have our data neatly summarized, or rather grouped, by the city. While we are here, let me tell you that we are not limited to just one column like in row fields. You can add more columns to this argument. Like currently we only have city under row fields. Let me add country and region to the mix as well. And instantly, that data is updated up here. Similarly, we can add more cells to our values argument. So let's select our value argument up here. And now let's add profit column to our formula like this. And we have the profit here too. Let's change the format to currency at this point so they look a little better. Done. Now we have all this data, which is only 30 rows in this example. But imagine hundreds of rows like this, and you can summarize it, or rather group it, by a simple formula like this. If you have noticed, we don't have any headers. And that brings us to our next argument, field headers. So edit our formula from here, and we have three options. 0 is for no, 1 is yes but don't show, 2 is no but generate, and 3 is yes and show. We'll mention 3 here, and we have our field headers. Next up is total depth, which is nothing but grand totals and subtotals. If you have been paying attention, we have had totals since the beginning without using this argument. So it looks like showing totals is a default setting. If we don't want them, we can choose 0 for our option in total depth, and our totals go away. If you wish to see both subtotals and grand totals, we can use option 2. And here we have the grand total at the bottom and subtotal in here. It doesn't really make sense about the subtotals in this data set since it just has one city and therefore it's simply repeating the value from the city again in subtotals. So let's just stick with grand totals for this example. And there's one more feature that I like. We can have grand totals and subtotals at the top. I'm going to have just the grand totals at the top by choosing this option here. And this helps me to check the totals without having to go all the way to the end if I had too many rows, which is quite useful. Next is sort order. And this one needs a number that will correspond to the columns in row fields and then the columns that we choose in values. As of now, our city names are sorted in ascending order. And if we wish to sort them by revenue instead, we simply have to go to edit the formula. Count the column and the revenue is at number 4, so we add 4 as sort order and here we have the list sorted by revenue. And it has smartly excluded the total up here, which is nice. If you wish to reverse the sort order, meaning if you wish to have it in descending order, all you have to do is put a minus symbol in sort order like this. And now we have our revenue in descending order. Last up is filter array, which as the name indicates is used to filter this. Let's say we don't want the results from Dubai in our group by result here. We use the filter array argument for that. Select the row for the city. Put a less than and a greater than sign to denote not equal to. And in double quotes mention Dubai. Press enter and Dubai is removed from the results. And it's not limited to the first row only. If you wish to remove, let's say, a region, it's the same drill. Select the row. Mention Europe in double quotes and Europe is removed from our results. As you must have gathered by now, this is a dynamic function, meaning any changes to your data will be reflected instantly in your result. You don't have to do a refresh like in pivot tables or press F9 to recalculate your formulas. Also, since it is a function, you can also nest it with other functions as well. For example, in a row fields argument, we have to select all from city name to region. But let's say you don't want to show the country, which is in the middle, you can choose CHOOSECOLS and HSTACK for this in row fields argument. So we start by GROUPBY and for row fields argument, we start with CHOOSECOLS. For array, we select a full table. Then we only need city and region, which is the second and fourth column. So we mention 2, 4 and close brackets and put a comma, which completes our row fields argument. And now let's choose for our values, revenue and profit. And for function, let's go for average this time and done. Now we have the city and region only. One more great use I can think of is using VLOOKUP to bring out the summarized value, which seems complex, but it's not really. Let's say you were given this data and you have to find the totals for each city. Most of us would use a pivot, which needs to be refreshed whenever any changes are made to your data. Instead, we can use VLOOKUP with GROUPBY to do it more cleanly and elegantly. Let me show you. But first, let me make a nice little drop-down of our city names. So we go to Data, Data Validation, List, and for Source, let's select our cities. Don't worry, it only shows unique values, so we are good. Hit OK and we have our drop-down here. Let's choose the first city, Berlin, in a drop-down and now let's write a VLOOKUP to get the totals. VLOOKUP, a lookup value is this, and for lookup array, we use GROUPBY for row fields, we just select the city name. Values is the revenue here, function is sum, close brackets, and our lookup array is done. Now for column index number, we enter 2, because our GROUPBY function has only city names and revenue will be column number 2. And last argument, put 0 and done. Here we have our total for Berlin by using a VLOOKUP formula. We can't verify this from our table on the top because we have excluded Europe from this result. But if we go to, let's say, Dubai in our drop-down, it matches perfectly. These are just two examples where you can nest GROUPBY with other functions. I'm sure if you put your mind to it, you'll be able to find more uses for this function in your line of work. That completes everything about the GROUPBY function. But it seems that this video has already taken up too much time and I wouldn't want it to be boring. So let's do the next new formula in the next video. So subscribe to my channel and don't forget the bell icon so you're notified when I publish that video, which will be up next. And the usual, like, comment and share this video. Until next time, happy spreadsheeting.